I just added a human-like AI agent to my Next.js app using only one React hook. No complex setup, no backend required, just pure conversational AI. This one single line gives you access to a fully featured AI agent that can listen to user voice input in real time, process natural language, respond with human-like speech with low latency, and handle conversational state automatically. Let me show you how this works. For this demo, I've created a wizard which will guide the user with their quest. Let's start the conversation.
Greetings, traveler. How can I assist you on your quest?
Greetings, wizard. May I know your name?
You may call me Callum. I am a wizard and I am here to help you on your quest. Remember, your goal is to collect 11 gemstones scattered throughout Labzonia. I can help you find them and overcome any obstacles
well met,
you may...
Callum. Sorry for interrupting you, but I do need to get a move on. People are waiting for me to finish this demo. Can you tell me more about the weapons that I need to complete this quest?
Ah, yes, the weapons. You will need a variety of weapons to complete your quest, traveler. Each gemstone is guarded by a different type of creature, and you will need the right weapon to defeat them. For example, you will need a sword to fight the goblin, a bow and arrow to defeat the flying creatures, and a magic staff to defeat the wizards. You can find these weapons scattered throughout Labzonia. So keep your eyes peeled.
Well, actually, sorry for interrupting you again, but I would also like to learn how to do magic.
Of course, traveler. Magic is an essential part of this quest. I can teach you some basic spells to help.
The potential for this is just absolutely insane. And best of all, you can also add custom tools as well as knowledge bases to your agents as well. So let's get started. Now, I don't want to spend too much time building the user interface, so I have created some boilerplate for you to get started. This way, we can simply focus on the SDK itself. In the description of the video, you will find a link to this GitHub repository. So to get this code, simply click on Code and then download the zip file, and then open the contents of that folder in your code editor. Let's install all the project dependencies by running npm install, or I'm actually going to use pnpm, but it's really up to you. Now, let's start the dev server by running npm run dev. Let's open this URL in the browser. Now, obviously nothing happens when we click on start conversation. We will be implementing all of this logic during the course of this video. And if we have a look at the code, we can go to the source directory. Then, if we have a look at the app directory and the page, there's really not a lot going on here. We've simply got a main tag with a heading, and the component that we'll be changing is this voice component, which we can find in the components folder. And if we open up this component, this simply contains the UI design for this voice component over here. I've simply gone ahead and created a few handler functions to start the conversation, to end the conversation, and to toggle mute. You can also implement a similar function for decreasing or increasing the agent's volume. We'll simply mute the volume entirely. And then we're simply using chatcn to create this very basic layout. And in this design, we have a button to mute the conversation. And within the main card content, we have another button to start the conversation. But as you can see, this is some very basic boilerplate. And now we'll have a look at adding our agent to this component. In order to create our agent, we will be using 11 labs. At the time of recording this, the conversational AI assistants are actually free to use, as they currently are in the beta phase. So this is the perfect time to play with this technology, as this will become very popular in the next year. Go over to 11labs.io or use the link in the description of this video to support my channel. Then sign up or sign into your account. We can then create our agent by going to the conversational section and then click on agents. Then let's click on create an AI agent. Here we can give our agent a name, like I'll just call mine wizard demo. Then we can select to start from scratch or start with one of these templates, like a support agent, a math tutor, or a video game character. And we'll use the video game character. Let's click on create agent. We're not going to change much on this agent, but I do briefly want to show you that we can set things like the welcome message, the system prompt, we can swap out the LLM provider, and we can also add a custom knowledge base and tool calling. I've already created a separate video which goes into detail on creating these agents along with using the knowledge base feature and providing tools to this agent. So definitely check out that other video if it's something you would be interested in. But for now, all we really want is to copy the agent ID, and then back in Next.js, let's create a new file in the root directory and let's call it .env.local. Then let's create a new variable called next_public_11labs_agent_ID. This variable will be publicly available, hence the next_public prefix. But don't worry about other people abusing this though, as I will show you towards the end of the video how you can ensure that this agent can only be accessed from your application and nowhere else. Then let's also paste in our agent ID. And now we can close this file. Then let's have a look at adding this agent to our application. The first thing we need to do is to install the 11labs library. So I'm going to close the session. And then in the 11labs documentation, we can find the React SDK page to see the installation instructions. So I'm going to use npm. So I'll simply copy this command and then run it in my terminal. Now that we've installed the 11labs SDK, we can start up the dev server again. And now at the top of the code, we can run import something from the 11labs React library. And what we want to grab is the use conversation hook. Then within our component, we can initialize that hook by creating a variable. I'll just call it conversation, which is equal to use conversation, like so. And now we can actually grab two objects from this hook. We'll grab something from conversation, and what we want to grab is the status and is speaking. So status will simply tell us if we are connected to the 11labs agent in the backend, and we can use is speaking to determine if the agent is currently speaking. When opening this application, we need to ask the user for permission to use their microphone. So let's start with that first. Below this handler functions, I'm going to use useEffect to ask the user for permission to use the microphone. We will add the logic in a second, and we won't add any dependencies as we only want this useEffect to run once when the page has finished loading. Let's create a new function called requestMicPermission, and this is an async function, and within this function we'll attempt to get permission to use the microphone. So we'll call await, then we'll call the navigator function in the browser, and on navigator we can reference the media devices, and on this we've got a method called getUserMedia, and within this method we can pass an object where we can set audio to true. So if the user permits access, this logic will simply continue. If they deny access, this will actually raise an exception. So to handle that exception, let's wrap this code in a try catch block. So I'll simply move this into the try block, and in the catch block let's simply console log error accessing microphone followed by the content of the error object itself. I want to keep track of this permission in state, and I also want to keep track of any error messages in state as well. So at the top of this function, let's create a few state variables. So first, let's create a state for has permission, and let's also create a set function called set has permission, which is equal to useState and the default value of false. This means that once a user permits access to their microphone, we can call set has permission to true. Otherwise, it will just remain as false. Let's also create state for the error message. So let's create a new state called error message with a set function called set error message, which is equal to useState with a default value of an empty string. And then let's go back to our catch block, and just below the console log, I'll call set error message, and we'll pass in error as error.message. So this will simply grab the actual string text from this error object. And lastly, let's also call this request mic permission function in our use state. And when we refresh this, we will be asked to permit access to the microphone. So I'll select allow while visiting the site. Now let's implement this start conversation button. So in our component, we've got this button that we can use to start the conversation, and it is hooked up to the handle start conversation function. Now if we jump over to this function, we can add our logic over here. Now to start a conversation with the 11labs SDK, we can simply create a new variable called conversation ID, which is equal to await. Then we can call our conversation object, which we instantiated over here. And on this object, we have a method called startSession. This method takes in an object as input, and the only property we want to pass in at this stage is the agent ID, which we saved in our environment variables. So to access it, we can call process.env.next_public_11labs_agent_ID. And TypeScript is simply saying that this value could be undefined, so I'll simply add an exclamation mark to remove this error, as we do expect the variable to be available. Then let's also console log something like started conversation, and let's also write out the conversation ID. So back in our app, we can open up the console and let's hit start conversation.
Greetings, traveler. How can I assist you on your quest?
We can see that the conversation has started, and we can also see our unique conversation ID.
Ah, yes, I see you're making progress on your quest.
Now we just need some way to stop the conversation as well. So let's implement that logic. So let's scroll down to this button where we start the conversation, and just above it, let's add another button. In fact, we can actually just copy this button as they do look identical. So let's copy this, let's paste it just above it. Let's change this text to end conversation. Then for this button, let's also add a variant, and this variant's value will be destructive. And for the handler function, we'll actually call handle end conversation. Let's remove this disable property. Then for the icon, let's change it from mic to mic off, like so. And if we look at the application, we can see the end conversation button with this different icon. Now we also want to conditionally show these buttons. So if we're not connected to 11 Labs, we can start the conversation. Or if we are connected, then we'll show end conversation instead. So just above this button, let's add some JavaScript code. And what we'll do is we'll check if the status is equal to connected, and we'll add a question mark. So if we are connected, we'll show something. Otherwise, we'll show something else. So what do we want to show when we are connected? Well, we want to show this button to end the conversation. So let's cut this code and paste it into these parentheses. And what do we want to show when we are not connected? Well, we want to show the button to start the conversation. So let's move that as well. And now if we go back to our app, we will initially see start conversation, and let's click on start.
Greetings, traveler. How can I assist you on your quest?
And now we're able to end the conversation as well.
Ah, so you've finally found all 11 gemstones. That's quite a feat, traveler.
However, we still have to implement the logic for this handle end conversation function. To end a conversation, we can simply call await conversation.endSession. Now let's give it a spin in the app. So let's start the conversation.
Greetings, traveler. How can I assist you on your quest?
And let's try ending it. Perfect. At this point, we've actually done it. We've added a real-time conversational agent to our application, but we're not done yet though, as I do want to show you one of the most important settings that you should add to your application as well. But first, I do want to show you how you can change the volume of the agent as well, or in our instance, we'll simply mute the agent entirely. So in this toggle mute function, we can call conversation dot set volume, and within set volume we can pass in an object, and in this object you have this volume property, and now you can set any value between 0 and 1. So what we can do is simply create a new state called muted with a set muted function, which is equal to use state and the default value of false. So in the handler function, we can have a look at our muted state, and if muted is true, then volume will be 1. Otherwise, volume will be 0. And then we can also set the value of the muted state variable, and this will simply be the opposite of what the value was previously. So if it was muted, we'll simply unmute, and vice versa. Then let's go to this button, which we can use to toggle mute. And what I'll actually do is copy this line, because I do want to show a different icon if we are currently muted. And this icon is called volume 2. So if I save this and go back to our app, we can see the two different icons. Now let's conditionally show the icons. So just above these icons, we can check the muted state. And if muted is true, then we'll show something, otherwise we'll show something else. So what do we want to show if we are currently muted? Well, we want to show this volume X component, otherwise we want to show this component over here. Now let's save this, and if I click on this button, we can see it swapping between muted and unmuted. I do want this button to be disabled if we are not currently connected to any agents. So that's very easy to implement. We can go back to this button, let's enter the disabled property, which is equal to, and what we want to do is check if we are currently connected to an agent. So we will have a look at the status state, and if this is not equal to connected. So if we're currently not connected to an agent, then we should not be able to click on this button, which we can't. Great. And that is how easy it was to add a fully functional real-time agent to our React application. Now, the last piece of advice that I do want to give you is to protect your agent from being embedded into other applications. Ideally, we will now deploy this app to production, which will give us some sort of URL endpoint. And we can tell the 11 Labs that only that URL is allowed to access this agent. To do that, we can go back to 11 Labs, then on our agent, we can go to security, and within the allow list, we can add the domains that should be allowed to access this agent. Any other domain will be denied. And if you want to further protect this, you can enable authentication as well, which will require the user to authenticate themselves before having access to this agent. Now, I do have a video that covers everything you need to know about building these AI agents in 11 Labs, from creating knowledge bases, to assigning tools, to embedding the agent into any website. So check out that video as well.